That's so satisfying. What do we think? Yeah, definitely printed different on the sticker paper for sure. There's like the lines on the other ones on the plain paper. Let me get it here. Firstly, obviously, way darker. Even though I changed the settings, this is the. No, actually, this is the second to darkest. I think this is the. No, this is the first test. This was the darker test. Look how much darker that is. This is the same. So I guess it was my printer settings that made it so. I don't understand why. I don't understand. Why is it so different? This is matte sticker paper too. Like, it does print a lot darker on the glossy stuff, I've noticed. That's so much darker. So I guess these are gonna be probably freebie stickers. Let me try again. Let's get these off first. Actually, no. Let's go ahead and I'm just gonna go straight for the matte sticker paper again. Let's peel the stickers while it prints. So let's go back here. The arm. So I'm gonna have to just restart this. This is the first one. This is the second one. I definitely prefer this one. I still wish It was a little warmer, but I don't know. I don't want to mess around too much and waste a bunch of materials when these are perfectly cute stickers. And then let's see how the glossy ones just printed out. What? What the heck? These look like black and white. Start making like completely new files for like the different papers. But we'll cut these. They're so cute. It's just not, it doesn't look very much like the original painting. Let's cut it out and see how we feel once they're in sticker form. That was so much easier to peel. So the next thing I need to do is take some photos so I can put these up on my Etsy shop. And I found this at Day Sewing. First saw it a while ago and I didn't get it. But then when I was in the process of taking all the other pictures of my other stickers, I was like, dang, I wish I had a good backdrop. So apparently it comes with these. So we're gonna choose one and see if it makes good pictures. I just wanted to put another quick clip in here to talk about another video that I'm planning to do, or I don't know, we'll see if I end up recording it. But basically I got this new sketchbook, which I did film myself opening. We'll see if that video actually makes it to YouTube, because at the same time I also received, well, opened these and tried them for the first time, which are the Stabilo Carbothello pastel pencils. And I did some swatching of those, but we'll see. I don't know. It wasn't like the best video. It was kind of long. But basically, the first thing I want to do in this new sketchbook is a gouache painting of Mr. Frodo Baggins. I don't know why. Well, I kind of know why. I've been rereading Lord of the Rings again for the millionth time, and I just can't stop thinking about the first page in the sketchbook being Frodo Baggins. That's it. And so the reason I have this printed out is because I really want to try using some carbon paper. This stuff I just got from Daiso. I've already used it before for a canvas painting. So I figured I might as well get some more use out of it, since I have a whole lot extra, and you can reuse the paper a lot of times. Like, you don't have to throw it away after the first use. So that's what I'm gonna do. We'll see if I record it. We'll see if I do it today. I don't know. I also plan on baking some cookies today, so maybe not for this vlog. Maybe not today, but another time, I hope. I'm gonna be able to paint Mr. Frodo Baggins.